this amazing thing. So please welcome Louise.
So, good morning. And that's the extent of my Danish, I'm afraid. So little by little, step by step. And huge thanks, firstly, to the team here, to everyone who entrusted me with this privilege to be presenting the Full Circle here to you today. It's the first time, I think, that we've done it in this fashion. Those who are involved in the Full Circle have been speaking about this project for the last year or more, rather more than a year now, including Max Egan, who was here with you last year. And he started to speak about the Full Circles project. So since then, we've been very, very busy indeed, a small team of people, core people, who I'll introduce you to. And yeah, I just take this time now to give you a better idea, I hope, of what the Full Circle project is about, and more importantly, how you can get involved. Because I think we're all aware that these conferences are a fantastic information source. We have some tremendous speakers here and in many other conferences, many other podcasts, an awful lot of information available to us these days. In fact, perhaps you could say information overload. I know my head sometimes feels as if it's doubled in size, so. I think you know what I'm saying. The question that we looked at very carefully was how to use this information wisely, how to filter information that we have inside us, as well as information that we're receiving from other sources, how to filter this into some sort of wise action. Because very often I think, I know the question I have when I leave the conferences is, okay, now I know much more than I did before, but what do I do? What do I do with that? What's going to make sense? And sometimes that can be quite an overwhelming question, and in fact we may not do anything at all, which is a shame because these people work extremely hard to bring the information to us that will make a difference. But it's up to us, that's you, me, to really try and make a difference. So the Full Circle Project is one suggestion. It's not the answer to everything, although it could be, but we can't make that claim. That will depend on you. It will depend on your participation. This is not a project that we have created like you would create a wonderful meal and present on a plate, ready to eat. This is a project where we invite you to help grow the food, prepare the food, make the dish together, put in the spices and the seasoning, so that we actually come up with a really new tasting food that we can eat together at the table. Yeah. So I'll move along because I know time is running and I don't keep time well. So the Full Circle, it's nothing new in reality. The circle, as we know, is one of our most ancient symbols or images, and we see it everywhere, we find it everywhere. You've probably been noticing as well the talks that we've had so far. There have been a lot of things represented by the circle. You could just lump it together as unity, and perhaps keep that in mind as we go through the talk today. So it's an old idea, but it was brought back into our conscious awareness. It's an idea that Max Egan started to talk about almost 2 years ago now. And it's an idea which is really, whose time has come, I believe. And since it's been talked about, it really has been taking shape. Although it's remained the shape of the circle, it's become full, really full of amazing ideas, inspirational approaches to the situation that we're currently facing. And at the same time, and this perhaps reflects back to a talk from Johan yesterday, it's empty. So it's full, but it's empty. There's a story to that as well, but I think I'll leave that for another day. But this concept of being full and empty at the same time, I resonate with very well, because in practicing Qigong, Chinese medicine, the concept of something called Wu. Wu is a kind of universe. It's a small word for a big thing. It means the universe, everything. But everything and nothing at the same time. So the nothing is potential. The nothing is something is full, like a pregnant womb. It's full of some new creation. And I'm going to say that I feel the Full Circle Project is really creating a portal for something new to be born. Does that make sense? Am I making sense? Good, I get some nods. That's great. Tell me, stop me when I'm not making sense. Aside from Max, we're really gathering in to help us form the base of the Full Circle. More good warriors such as Ole Damagad and Zen Gardner, and actually many others who are there supporting the circle and contributing to it in their own way. They're not necessarily all known people, they're not necessarily all researchers or investigators. There are also many artists, writers, and you know what? Many ordinary people like you and me. And that's what's making the difference right now. We're all pulling together, standing up for life. I'd like to introduce you to the website, and I really encourage you to go onto the website and explore. It's, again, full, hopefully not too full, of many interesting aspects to the project. And we've really tried to encompass as many ways of approaching this situation that we face as possible. So I'll move on quickly because time really is running. Our response is a full spectrum response. This means that we're calling on people now, artists, as I say, writers, researchers, everyone, to bring in their knowledge and to bring in their understanding of how to approach the situation that we're confronting. On the website is something very special. This is the Community Connector. What this does is draw together people across the world. You can see here some representation of the world. And you can put a certain amount of information onto here, which will help you to find people in your location that you can meet up with, those of a similar mind, open mind, and I'll add open hearts as well. This can result in the meeting of those open minds and open hearts. And as you know from this type of conference, it makes a huge difference to the nature of how we think when we can share our ideas with others. This is essential that we do this in reality, using the technology of the website, but not staying too long on it. Coming into the website, taking the information that we need, making the contacts that we need, and going off and participating, being active in our community. So again, I'm just giving you an idea of the kind of atmosphere that can be created. I'm sure you're familiar with this, but not everyone is, to know that drawing people together in circles of focus and circles of care really create something very special. It's a very special energy, very special dynamic. We encourage people to keep the circles of focus small because this means that everyone gets a chance to have a say, and it also prevents too much infiltration. Events such as this one can be found on the website too, but again, the main idea is to come together looking at areas of common concern. Common concern means things that you care about in your community. This is done because to get people's attention, which, as we know, is one of the greatest resources at the moment that's being distracted, to get people's attention, we need to give them some cause for care, some cause for concern. This is often lacking at the moment, that I don't care. Where I come from, this is very strong. Me da igual, I hear all the time. It's all the same to me. So it's reminding people of what they care about, bringing them together, finding resources, reminding people that they are their own best resources, and bringing this together, creating strategies. I'm sorry I'm rushing, but I realize that time is short. And again, bringing people together, not just sitting and listening, but really being active, really being involved in ways that make sense to you in your community. This creates that unity, it creates resilience, it creates relationships, trust, etc., etc. Where does this lead to? In my community where I live in Spain, this is the village of Casares, over a period of time, I've been running a full circle group there now for over a year, year and a half, and just recently we've been invited into the town square to speak about the full circle project. This to me is a huge leap. This means essentially that we're breaking through the boundaries of people like us and people like them. People that maybe don't grasp the full picture or even part of the picture, but nonetheless are aware in themselves that things are not right. Something's wrong in the world. They may not be able to put their finger on it, but they know. And therefore they respond. And they respond by listening. And they respond by participating. And this is so essential. Here you can see that I'm not alone doing this, which is great because no one can do this alone now. This is why we need to be together. And I have a group of Spanish activists, and actually this is Willem here too, for those that know Willem. He's come down to Spain to help from Holland to help support the Full Circle project. So again, breaking boundaries. We have boundaries broken between, or perceived boundaries, I should say, no? Boundaries between nationalities, between ages. Here you'll see, I think in the other photograph here, we have some children with us. They're so essential to this process. And we also have an 81-year-old activist who's so powerful and dynamic in what he's saying. Coming together, this is a journalist, an angry ex-journalist here, and we have also a number of politicians on the stage with us. What we're doing is we're reaching through to people with common sense. Finally, we're using our common sense to connect together. This is perhaps the one thing that people are looking for that actually gives us a purpose, our unique individual common sense. When something makes sense to people, then they can respond and participate fully. I'll skip through these because this is just, you can find them there. It's all there on the website. It's an indication that the atmosphere we create around these talks that we have around the exchanges is one of as much creativity and imagination as possible. Music is a great way to bring people together. We all know that. So combine it with the talks. Combine it with any kind of gathering that you have. Oh, am I going backwards? Gatherings are happening. This is a full circle gathering in the UK. It's a great place to gather, no? In the pub, why not? this is another gathering over in Uruguay. So again, there's many of these circles coming together now. It can happen in your area. It can happen where you live if you organize it. And the Full Circle Project is there to help you do that. We can act as a resource. We can supply you with ideas. We can supply you with a big drum if you need one, because we're really beating a different tune. I feel that we're calling in people now. This is the warrior Spirit that's being called in. And when I speak to people on the phone who are participating with us, they really, some of their words are actually, I hear the call. I hear you. I've been waiting for this call. So there is really something on an energetic level here too. When we're beating the drum, we're calling in the community from their tasks, and we're saying, we have something to do here now. We really do. A quick example is Louise. This is a woman who you may not have heard of. You should. I recommend among thousands of other people who are responding to the Full Circle's request to collaborate. And she's a woman who has basically responded immediately. She's an Indigenous chief. And she has said, Sister, I hear you. I know what we're facing. We need to come together and heal this now. And these are the words that flow into the circle and, of course, flow out of the circle too. So they're words of genuine truth. They're people, warriors. I call Louisa a warrior. There are many of us. This is the spirit that we carry inside when we realize the urgency of the times and the opportunity within that. Circles of many shapes and sizes and colors coming together. That one keeps appearing, doesn't it? That full spectrum. Why full spectrum response? Why do we need this now? We need it because this is what we're facing. This dark energy, call it what you will. Devil, I know you're out there. I think we even need, we've reached the stage where darkness is so dirty and so sullied by all the perverse things that we're allowing to happen. That we need to even clean up the darkness. You know, even the darkness can have some light in it. And I know this is a lot to take in a few minutes, but we're looking at this too. We're looking full spectrum, full circle, at every possibility of approaching this virus, this parasite that seems to be so prevalent in our world at the moment. One of the main objectives with the full circle is once we have all this energy together in a circle, rather than go round and round and round wondering what to do with it, do we go here, do we look here, chemtrails, vaccines, etc., is that we take it and we focus it, and we focus it at the very thing which is most evident to most of us at the moment. You know, he's a poor guy, I don't know why I chose him, but he's representative of the government, this weird entity that at the moment we're giving the name. You may have heard Max speaking about the kakistocracy, takes some practice actually. But we know what he's talking about. It's a shit government, right? I mean, no matter where you look, I know I'm not talking about individuals, but the entity itself is highly contaminated. And if something is contaminated in an ill environment, we need to look at that illness and we need to find a remedy, we need to find a cause, and we need to find a remedy, and we need to apply that medicine and heal the thing. If we don't heal the thing, it will come back again and again and again. And I think this has been proven, and I have to race through a little faster. So don't do this. I know it looks tempting just to walk away. It really is. And I know perhaps at other times that would have worked. But what we're feeling, truly feeling, is that if we can face this thing now, face the beast full on, you know, all the other talkers, we're all talking about the same thing now. We're naming the beast. And it's about time we stood up to it, because together we really can be strong enough to overpower this thing with true power, once we know who we are. So we're using a legal framework in order to highlight the abusive relationship that we currently have with our governments throughout the world and we the people, the human family. And I'm going to skip through that. But the key, this is one of the principal keys to everything. When we recognize that we do have the resources, we do have the tools, we even have the knowledge, when we connect again and become coherent and aligned with who we truly are, then we will find that we've had the key all along. that we don't have to search for it any longer, and we don't have to have this type of world because it only exists in the current storyline. We don't have to keep feeding our energy to a dead corporation, as I call them. Thank you. Thank you. This slide is here simply to remind us that we're playing a game. We're involved in playing a game. I'm bored with this game. Are you?
Yeah.
So this board game you can see is being supported by people who are bent over. I suggest, the full circle suggests, we now stand up and go play another game, another story. One which is full of vitality. All rise, as the shirt says there. So I really invite you to come with your warrior spirit. Start where you are, use what you have, and do what you can. That's all it takes, okay? In every aspect, that's all it takes. Connect with your heart, because this is through using compassion and empathy that we really can reach through to everyone, and I mean everyone. I've witnessed this in my village. I know it works. There's an alchemy here in the circle. I'll talk about that some other time, but it's really strong. This circle is very strong because it has the combination of female energy, the circle, and a very direct focus. This is thanks to the male energy. So it's an absolute balance of energies, creating a dynamic like I've never, ever experienced. And I so wish everyone here and anyone watching, step in, participate, experience this. You'll be so encouraged in your life, and you will be doing the right thing. I promise you this. So in Lakesh, I'm another you. Just do it. Thank you. Do visit. Thank you.